Welcome to your doom.
Shut it and get up here.
Massive uppercuts!
Hello and welcome to another edition of the Jab Jab Show. Today I'm making a video that I've been hinting at in some update videos that I've recently been doing. It's a series of videos that I wanted to do when I started my YouTube channel. When I was thinking about ideas of how to, what I'm gonna do on the channel and things like what's important, what's kind of important, and what I'm passionate about and things. So this is a series of videos that. As my channel evolves, and I didn't know how this idea, particular idea, would fit in with what I was doing and so forth. So I've been going through as per the previous videos. I'm making some videos that don't necessarily fit completely in what my channel's about and so on. But I did a recent gardening video. I'm not about gardening at all, but it's some videos I want to fit in, and I want to do these videos because they do tie in some ways to retro games and films and so on. So what it is basically is a series of videos based on old video shops that I used to go to and I knew of growing up. And the video shops, some of the video shops, ended up being DVD shops and so forth, that's not renting DVDs and stuff, like, as the times moved on and so on. And the videos I wanted to make, it's because of the whole how we, as society, whatever, has, how it's evolved from, we don't have these anymore, we don't have the video shops anymore, or the DVD shops, things like that, the last one standing, certainly for me, was Blockbuster Video. The shops have gone now, and the whole ritual of Friday night, Saturday night, whenever, going to these places and seeing, a ton of films, ton of everything, things stacked up floor to ceiling of titles. Whole ritual of picking a video out, be it a new release, be it a cartoon of some kind, or be it a cheap knockoff of a more successful film, things like that. You'd pour over the cover, and you decide to pay up for, I don't know, new releases, £3 a day, £3.50 for a couple of days, whatever the price was, or for a cartoon, an animated film. Be £1 a week, or an older film would be £1 a week, things like that. The whole ritual of doing that is all gone now. It does make me genuinely sad that my son can't do that, won't have that experience of going into a shop, a video shop, DVD, that kind of thing, where and just look at what they've got and pick something out and taking your time. Oh, what about this one? Looking at the covers, that kind of thing. That's gone now. It's been replaced, as you will be aware, of streaming systems. You've got your Netflixes, Amazon Primes. You've got lots of, I don't know how many, but you've got lots of things. While it's convenient, I get the whole clicking, scrolling, clicking, reading the short synopsis, and that'll do, bugger it. And obviously, provided you've got the bandwidth, you've got the kind of the internet speed and whatever, just watch it and it streams and all that, on TV or wherever you watch it, on laptop, computer, wherever. That's convenient, obviously, for a lot of people. When I was, I'm going through. Plus, also when I had the flu-like symptoms, I would, I just find it easier, obviously, to just, I ain't got the energy to go down and get a DVD, pick out a DVD off of the many I've got, the Blu-rays, whoever, and just say, right, that'll do, that film, I'll just watch it because my mind, I'm finding it difficult to kind of concentrate on whole films. Not so much in the cinema, that's a thing in itself, but in terms of films, I'm not so bad now, but when I was going through the flu like symptoms and not, I thought it's much easier just to flick some, put something on the streaming thing, watch it. But I do miss and I do love the trailers you got before the film, and adjusting the tracking. Just a little thing, the Beacon Rewind, like little stickers on the thing, which I'll go on to, in the subsequent videos. I miss that. You don't obviously get that, and it's all clean and pristine. And I've watched a couple of documentaries about people who collect videos and VHS tapes and the whole history of VHS tapes, things like that, and it's chronicling collectors and what their collections and why they collect and things like that. And it got me back into video collecting, and just more of an appreciation of videos. And one of the things were, one of the points. And one of them, or maybe both of the documentaries are saying, as time goes on, as each format comes on, you got VHS, you got DVD, you got Blu-ray, you got 4K Blu-ray, and obviously streaming systems come out, you're getting less and less choice. A lot of the things, a lot of the films, obviously documentaries and that kind of, other things, you'd get on video won't be translated ever on to DVDs. A lot of them, I'm surprised, a high percentage of films that didn't get transferred to DVD, and you get even less when you go into Blu-ray, and you get even less on streaming. Because I like a lot, I've got a broad choice kind of taste in films, and I'm looking at the selection I've got on certain streaming systems, and I've heard of most of the films. They're all mainstream films. They've all been at the cinema. They've all been at the some of them straight to DVD perhaps, but a lot of them just just at the cinema. Like I was saying before about Blockbuster Video being the last one standing, as at least where I live, Blockbuster Video, in these two documentaries, I'll just mention that they are not shown in a particularly nice light, because this company was the big conglomerate who would just hoover up business from like mom independent video stores, mom and pop stores, that kind of thing, where they had so much money behind them, they could afford to get the new releases, dozens of copies. I remember one of the slogans they had, I can't remember what year they kind of had this slogan, how long, but you go into the Blockbuster near me, and it would say something along the lines of, if you don't have the film you want, you'll get it free next time you're in. So you look at the top 20 charts of the films, and they are pretty much all the films that were at the cinema, and they had the money to buy the copies, so they can have dozens of each film. So I don't know, maybe they did at some point have times when they didn't have a particular film because it's such in high demand, perhaps that was the case. But they had more money than say the little independent stores who had a couple of copies of a new release, because each copy was about 90 quid, or probably even more maybe. And they rely on rentals obviously to make that money back. They didn't have the money to compete with Blockbuster in the long run, and it's sad, I can see that. So even saying that, like, Blockbuster is like the kind of the mainstream populist kind of video store, I still felt sad that that's not around anymore. For my son, and because it's from a bygone era, people under a certain age would think, what are you on about, just click stream, what's the point in doing that? And it seems a bit of a faff. I get that, but this is the thing, this I wanted to highlight in my video, me on my channel. I'm doing it now, series of videos I mentioned on my previous update video. I did go out on the Sunday just gone, filming a few things, so we'll be adding, interspersing, a shot of, you'll see anyway, in front of what used to be a video store. So, without further ado, let's get on with it. Now, the first video shop I'm going to highlight in this series, if you will, is one that was called Wasp Video. Now, I'm not sure of why it was called Wasp Video. I mean, I have an image from Stockport Heritage website of, it was called something else back in the early 80s, so this actual shot was like always a video shop from, well, at least since the early 80s, it's like changed hands management over time, I'm guessing. So there is a video of me, you know, outside what is now a different shop, obviously. It's either the nail place or it's the whatever the other shop is about. You know, you can say down below in the comment section what's best, nails or videos. Also on the Wasp video, there was a video game section that I loved, and they were charge at least. It was, the base rate was £3.50 to part exchange your game. Obviously, depending on your game and what game you wanted to part exchange it for, the price could increase. They had a book, or like a manual, whatever it was, catalog, which said what the valuation of the games were. Now the video shop had, I know it had 16-bit stuff, and incidentally, this was the only shop that I've seen Final Fight Guy in for the Super Nintendo. At the time I didn't have a Super Nintendo. I don't know, but I swapped my games loads there. My Mega Drive games. I've been to so many games, swapped them so many times at this particular shop and other video shops, and you know it would be. It'd be one of the things, and you're probably wondering why I'm holding up this on the thumbnail. Perhaps you are, I don't know. Alex Kidd in the Enchanted Castle. Okay, it wasn't this actual copy. I'll go on to it, but basically, I had a friend at school, who had this, and I went to his house and I played it, and I borrowed it off him. Okay, this game. Incidentally, I bought this off eBay and several years later, you know, all the rest of it. Anyway, I liked it, and I don't know what came over me, but as I mentioned, I was in the habit of swapping games, part exchanging games. And I part exchanged my friend's game for something. I don't know why, and I can't remember what game for, but I part exchanged his game. It's his game. It was, you know, he lent it me. I had it for, I don't know, maybe a week or 2 weeks. And then I part exchanged it for something. It wasn't mine to do that. Anyway, I did that. Anyway, whatever game. And he said to me one day, soon afterwards maybe, oh, have you still got Alex Kidd? I went, yeah. Obviously no, but I said, yeah. Can I have it back? Can I lend it for a little bit longer? I said to him. Okay, so a few days passed, whatever. Can I have Alex Kidd back? And I said, I'm still playing it, you know, still keeping up this game, if you will, or this charade, whatever. And says, oh, all right, okay. And a few days after, whatever, and he came back, you know, oh, my mum wants me to get the game back. I thought, oh, okay. I'll get it back. I'll bring it back when I'm finishing playing with it. So I thought, oh, listen. He's not giving up. But why would I think otherwise? You know, it's his game. You know, so I thought, okay. I'll have to go. I'll go back to the Wasp video and get it back. I'll swap whatever game. Do you know? Obviously, out of my money, I'll get the game back. You know, didn't have it. It'd gone. You know, someone else. I don't know. Bought it or whatever. And this Alex Kidd game, certainly where I shopped and whatever, it was quite rare, and I hardly saw it anywhere, you know. You had your Sonics, you had your Corporations, you had your Last Battles, you had Jimmy White, World and Snooker, FIFA, you know, you had the usual suspects, but I hardly ever saw Alex Kidd. And where I did see Alex Kidd was about 35 quid or something, you know, it's at my price range. So I thought, what am I going to do? They didn't have it on the shelves, and I'm of the belief that if you go into a shop and they don't have a thing on the shelves, what you're looking for, they probably don't have it, so I don't ask. So I was thinking, what do I do here? You know, what do I do? So I just kept up what I was doing. Oh, my mum really wants to know, get Alex Kidd back. And I said, look, I'm still playing with it. Can I buy it off you? I said, that's my offer. Can I buy it off you? I said, and he's on, oh, I don't know. So this has gone on for a week or two, and his mum, he's saying his mum really don't want to sell it. I said, look, I'll give you 15 quid for it. I don't know where this 15 quid was going to come from, but I said, I'll give you 15 quid for it. And in the end, he relented. I carried on. And he relented. Say, yeah, 15 quid. It might have been 20, might have been 10 quid. I can't remember. It was a price that, you know, I paid. So basically, that's the story behind Alex Kidd, which I want, I'll play in a video. I'll do a gameplay video at some point soon, because it's a pretty jaunty game. All that. So I just want to share that, And so that was the story behind Alex Kidd, and I don't know why I did what I did by exchange someone else's game, but I did. I know of a friend who, for example, swapped a dog for Strider, an actual real life dog, like a pet. Some kid had the game Strider for the Mega Drive, which is really good, by the way. He swapped it for a dog. I don't know how true that is, but apparently that's what he did. And basically, you walk into Wasp Video, as it was, you'd have your new releases, at the front, someone catch your eye, that's out of video now, go in and get it. Then it kind of funnel in the way it was designed, it'd funnel a little bit. You'd have the person who worked there, like behind the counter, watching whatever it is on the TV, they put a video on, not a film on. And then you'd have the video games. That's where I saw the Final Fight guy and other, everything else they had. And also at the back, they'd have the adult section, which, you'd have to do the kind of walk of shame past the cashier to, have a little, you look at a game where you'd have it, I wouldn't, obviously, my friend would, and my friend. We would do that. So that's basically Wasp Video, which I use loads. And I like membership. I do remember renting out me, you. What's he called? You, me, and Irene. I can't remember the Family Brothers film from 2000. Was it 2000? It's a bit noisy outside. I do apologise. I was like, making the roads, better or something. So I do apologise for the sound. It's probably showing up. But that was Me, You and Irene. That's the Family Brothers film. It was 2001. The film came out maybe that year or the year before. I'll put in captions. I think it was year 2000, but I can't be sure. I think the Wasp Video did close in maybe mid-2000s. I remember buying or looking at selling off a lot of stuff, and I do have a few videos like this one, White Men Can't Jump, 1992, directed by Ron Shelton, very good film. Woody Allison and Wesley Snipes on it. I don't know why I had to. I do have a few videos from there, a few accidentals. See, I find that very cool Wasp Video on there. I've watched this loads. And I guess I paid $5.99 for it. This is the cover. But what did puzzle me, I did get this from Primetime Video, among others. It does have Bond Street Video. I've not changed the box to go with the cover. It came exactly how it is. I don't know how it came to be in the possession of Wasp Video, if it was from Bond Street Video originally. I don't know. So there's Wasp Video for you. Big thing in my childhood. Throughout, like I say, I'm going to go through a few other video shops, as and when I can get them kind of like up. I've written a few things down. I'm going to write down a few more things. This, maybe Saturday coming up or Sunday, I will be doing some more filming, much similar to what I showed in this video, just to highlight some of the stuff. There's Wasp Video. Anyone get any comments on any video shops they used to go to frequently as a child growing up? Did they have video games? What video games? Have you got any anecdotes and things like that? That's what I'm gonna do. The reason originally, I should have said this at the start, I might edit this. originally I wanted to say what I want to say about the video shop actually outside the video shop. Production value, production wise, I'm thinking as it's on a busy road, I thought, okay, it's not going to be, you know, convenient. I mean, like I said, I shot all the shot what I did on a Sunday morning. I'm guessing it was about 8:40 on a Sunday morning. It's still fairly busy. It's on the main road. You see, you know, as I shot it, there's several cars that I had to wait before I could cross the road and things like that. I had to wait for people to pass because further down there a little bit, there's a little convenience store. People go in for papers, milk, whatever, and so they're passing all the time. I don't feel I could have said what I wanted to say outside the store without being interrupted several times. People walking past, you know, doing this and that, car noises, all sorts. It just wasn't going to happen. That's why I chose to do what I'm doing now as a format kind of thing. So, as I say, that's how it's going to be. It's easy to do what I'm doing now. Production-wise, I won't be able to, you know, it might have been raining, it might have been cold, it might be windy, all that kind of thing. So, I don't know. This is what I'm going to do. So, as I say, I'm going to upload other videos about video shops and stuff. It's like things close to my heart. I've got a lot of passion, got a lot of memories about. So yeah, anyone out there who has memories of some video shops, any videos that you've done that I might have missed, you know, about video shops that you used to go to and things, this is a genuine interest for me. You know, obviously it ties in, as I say, with films and specifically video, you know, VHS, and obviously, you know, video games as well. So, you know, just let me know down below in the comment section and all the rest of it. Thanks for watching and see you later. Do it, 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 do it